Welcome back to The Five. Well, you may have heard about this story. Robin Gardner went missing in Aruba 2 weeks ago, and now investigators believe they have a major break in the case. Gardner was traveling with Gary Giordano when she disappeared, and now authorities have discovered that Giordano took out a $1.5 million accidental death insurance policy on her. Well, right away to me, Eric, that's suspicious. In a lot of these cases that we've, covered, in cases I've prosecuted, right away the prosecutor looks to see, was there a life insurance policy? He could have taken a cheaper one out for 5 years. Instead, he took the more expensive one. One-year policy.
Two things to note. Number one, if you're blonde and female, maybe you want to stay away from Aruba for a while. But,
yeah.
But Kim, why can someone take a life insurance policy out on someone they've just met?
Well,
they have to sign off on that and agree to it?
Yeah, well, she obviously did agree to it, but the basic issue here is he took one out for himself and one for her prior to traveling on this trip, but they didn't even know each other very long. They met, not to give it a bad name, but on Match.com. They hadn't known each other very long. She agreed to accompany him on this trip, and then he's the last person that she was seen with. He's given inconsistent statements, and they're going to continue to hold him in custody for another 16 days. And there's also some evidence, forensics, Bob, of some DNA blood evidence that they're going to be examining near where she disappeared on
They get any pictures of her in her prom dress? it's not funny. I'm sorry. It's not funny, but no.
You're on a timeout.
Listen, I just want to say that anybody that ends up going on a Match.com or Backpage or one of those places.
They're different. Match.com is just an online dating service.
Oh, it is?
Backpage is actually what you use.
Oh, okay.
But, no.
The point is, did you see the picture of the two of those people? Now, do you think that woman should have gone with that dog down to Aruba?
Probably not.
Yes.
But here's the thing, though. When people, talk about this online stuff, how is an online any more dangerous than meeting somebody in a bar? Like if she had met some guy at a bar.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, well,
going in your mental way back machine,
yeah.
Bob? Some bad things happened to you
not
in a bar.
So far back.
Well,
yeah.
But he also has this is the big point here. If you're looking, investigate the case. This is a guy who actually has arrests.
Right.
There's issues there with domestic violence, assault of conduct on women. There's an ex-girlfriend who spoke out that said that he was peering into her house with some kind of mask on and frightened her at night. And he also was making illicit sex tapes.
And he has terrible hair.
He looks like your friendly neighbor next door, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Now, if you know all this about him, I assume this woman didn't even check into his background. I mean, she just decides to up and go. Not that I mean, it's a sad story, but I mean, frankly, the other thing I might say is this is now how many of the 99th blonde woman we've done a story on over the years, and that's missing. I'm just curious if this was somebody, for example, who was black and was missing, would we be doing a story about this? Every time we have these stories, it's a good-looking blonde woman who disappears, and in this case, with this dog off of a website.
Smoke them if you got them.
I think that they want to
smoke them if you got them, Bob. We're
going
to talk about cigarettes now, okay?
I knew that was coming.
Yeah, cigarette labels. So this is a big story now about tobacco companies up in arms. They're bringing a lawsuit because they're being compelled to put these very graphic warnings, in fact, pictures of what can happen to you if you smoke cigarettes. So it's not just warning about the dangers or that there are carcinogens in there. If you take a look at that, these are actually going to be on the boxes or the labels of cigarettes. They have to be on there by fall of 2012. You have a choice of one of nine of them, cigarette makers, that you can choose from, but they have to go on there. So four of the five largest U.S. tobacco companies, they are steaming, smoking hot, mad, and they brought a big lawsuit against the U.S. government. And they say, hey, look, this infringes on our First Amendment rights and free speech. And why are we being singled out, Greg?
Well, I think, as an industry. It's glad they finally grew a pair. If you're going to do this for cigarettes, then you got to do it for fattening foods, show fat people on there. And if when there's a Gwyneth Paltrow movie showing, they got to have on the poster people throwing up.
Oh my goodness.
I'm very troubled by this. I knew that this legislation was going through the Congress when I was White House Press Secretary, and President Bush had a veto threat on it every single time. And I think he was right to, because it is a First Amendment issue. They are trying to force private companies to be the spokespeople for their public policy position.
Yeah.
If you take this to its next logical conclusion, because cigarettes are still a lawful product. Now, if they want to have that conversation, we can do that. Say it's wine. And can you imagine the liberals in Nancy Pelosi's district are going to accept on their $100 bottle of wine a
picture of a drunk driving.
Wait one second. If somebody knows a little bit of something about wine and alcohol, I know it does kill a few people, but these people kill 440,000 people a year with this product, and this product ought to be made illegal. Now, I smoke little cigars. I'll admit that.
But that's not what she said.
If
they want to make it illegal, let's have that fight. But as long as it's legal, you can't compel somebody to, on your product, say, don't buy this.
Make it as disgusting as you can. I mean,
how many people die in car accidents? Should every car ad show carnage? Sure.
It's again, if we're singling out an industry again, anti-business practice.
It's a poison industry, Eric.
No, it's not.
It's a poison industry.
Dana points out the most important part of this story is that cigarettes are still legal. If they were illegal, if it were heroin or methamphetamine,
go ahead, Dana.
This statistic, I think, is the most interesting. The FDA's own study says that it would only decrease smoking by 0.088%.
Yeah, that's
so why are we doing this?
So why not? Why do we allow these guys to sell this crap is what I want to know. It kills people.
Bob, how do you distinguish between like cigarettes and, you know, alcohol?
How about this? Cigars that you smoke?
I just admitted I smoke cigars, and in terms of alcohol, if they had a picture of when I was drinking, my brain would have been scattered. But that's the point. It probably wouldn't stop me from drinking. I grant you that. Not much did. But for little kids to see this stuff, it may affect teenagers, and they may not pick this crap up. And these guys, you know why this stuff is legal? It's because they got the highest paid lobbyists in Washington, D.C. It's the only reason it's legal. It's got 400 and some odd combination of chemicals in it that kill people. And screw them. Let them have that thing. I would put on dead people on every corner of it.
Oh, my goodness.
No,
So you have no problem with it being on the front, the back, the side?
On the cigarette itself.
I'll bet you the tobacco companies win this lawsuit.
Of course they will, because they'll buy their way out of it like they do everything else.
Bob, we appreciate your passion.
Thank you very much. I noticed you wanted me to get off that story on Aruba real fast,
I was trying. Doing my best.
That's
pull the ripcord. Coming up, can you imagine only Democrats like Bob living on an island together? Do you find that sexy? And then another island with only Republicans living together? Sounds fun. Well, one billionaire libertarian is planning just that for his party. Well, that's next on The Five. Choose your island. We'll be right back.